We're not supposed to. We're supposed to say cute and polite and kind and pretty and dainty.
Writer, director, actress.
So.
Funder.
Funder.
Craft service. I don't know. I drove myself. I baked my own bread. I literally did.
She has to.
I have to. I have celiac disease. So I literally baked my own bread. Made my peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. I did everything on this film.
Why?
I did everything on this film because I had to. The movie takes place in a mafia setting, but it's really not about that. It's really about finding a voice in a world that tells you not to have one. And I think there's so many people, especially women, that really understand that message. So I grew up around mafia in my neighborhood. My family wasn't involved, but the people around me were, and I was a little girl. And then growing up and being a teenager, and I saw these young women with a rage that I cannot explain. And it really stayed with me. And the violence I saw from these young women was more than the mafia kid boys, because they were, the parents were all mafia, and these were the children. And the violence I saw from these young women was something that I really cannot explain. And their rage stayed with me for very, very, very many years. And I was frightened my whole life because of them, but because also in my home. So I left when I was probably 17, 18 years old, put myself through acting school, and I thought, ugh, I guess they're angry because their families are in the mafia. Maybe I'd be pissed off too. And I left, and I left that world behind. And when I went into my life and being a female, being told in the business who I was, oh, you're ethnic, so you're going to get put in this box. Because at the time, I was told I wasn't the girl next door. I wasn't, you know, blonde, blue-eyed. I didn't speak completely properly. I was from New York, and that had this level of who you are. So it was a box, a box, a box, a box. And then as I got older and into the business and I grew up and I really started to see what was really going on, and I realized that the ceiling for me in the business was a ceiling that I was already hitting my head on. And then go further and started to get into the rights of women and not being even in the Constitution and, you know, things like that. And the rage that I saw in these young women started to become my own. And it made me realize it had nothing to do with their fathers being in the mafia. It's that they had no choice. They were born into a slot that they did not choose. And I feel that is a sentiment that so many people could relate to, whether it be mafia or poverty or gender or drugs or alcoholism, you know, anything. And how you maneuver or have enough tenacity, enough self-worth to make that change, and sometimes going against everything you know. So that's what the movie is about. That's why it's hitting audiences the way it is, because it's not just another mafia film, which I will add, a mafia film that you've never seen the women in. We've never seen the women of these genre films, never. You got the master of them, Mr. Scorsese, the Irishman. This is a perfect opportunity to show about that daughter. We didn't see anything. We didn't see anything. And I question as to why. Why? Because they were interesting to me when I grew up. And, you know, I thought it was time that we showed what they had to say. Why haven't we had a mafia film from the perspective of a woman? I'm not quiet and thinking because I don't know my answer. I'm quiet and thinking because it's so much. Because no one gives a damn.
Yeah.
They don't think it matters. They don't think it matters. When this came out and people saw what I did, the amount of people in the business that said, wow, I didn't think of that. That's pretty incredible. That's pretty incredible. How did you not think of that? This genre has been done over and over and over and over. And some of the biggest, The Godfather, the most classic movies, but yet you didn't think of that? We were reduced down to, and being an Italian American, we were reduced down to a hand, that classic table scene where you got all the guys and they're all smoking and they're thinking about what they're gonna do. And don't get me wrong, they're amazing films. But there goes the hand. Tony, can I bring you some coffee? We all talk like idiots. We bring the coffee and then they're in the back. Or you got the naked girl on the pole in the back. Hey, look it over there. And she's wiggling her ass.
Or like, a victim of abuse.
Or a victim of abuse. And I thought, well, those are none of the girls I saw. Where are the girls that, what happened to the women with the dreams and the hopes and the children who had the moms, whether they knew or not what they were getting involved with, that's one thing. But the children and the girls, where was their choice? And they're not brought up to say, hey, go get an education and go, because they're so in a space where there is no room to move either way. And that's where the rage comes from. And you see it every day. Every day, every single day. I see more and more people that are oppressed. There's rage. There's oppression. There's going to be rage.
You wanted to give the voice of the women.
Mm-hmm.
Was no one interested?
No.
So
no one was interested. I will tell you how it went down. From that time of me seeing these young women, I always had this idea. I had this idea of like, what if we saw from their point of view? It stayed with me since I was like 16. I went through my career and like I said, it grew, it snowballed. And every time I'd hit a door or get hit in the face with something in the business, and that was quite often, I would go, you know what to do. Because I wanted to be a filmmaker, but I didn't see any representation of a female filmmaker when I was coming up. And I wanted to go to NYU and go to film school. I didn't have the money, so I thought, I'll tell stories as an actress. I'm like, whoa, that's nowhere near the same. It's really not, it's nothing like it.
Can you explain that?
Yeah, because as an actress, you're hired to say someone's words. I'm part of create a story, but I'm not creating the story. And as an actress, you're supposed to look pretty, shut up, say your lines, hit your mark, stay skinny and young, and you'll be fine. And just go, yep. Uh-huh, yep, yes. But like, people really don't understand really how deep this goes in the industry. And a lot of people, oh, it's changing, isn't it? No, it's really not. It's really not. Listen, the biggest positions of power of who's funding the movies and who's picking the movies that get funded and then who buys the movies to get distributed, it's all men. Love men, great. But when you are picking from one perspective, you are not going to be able to pick and choose for all. So you're coming at it from one perspective. Like, this is what I know this audience likes. And then you've got, it's not even art anymore, it's Wall Street. It's all based on money. Whereas in the past, we did have pockets of like, It meant something else, but it is all on an algorithm now. It is all on a singular perspective. And you gotta really think about it. If you had power, do you wanna give it up and share it?
No.
No, you don't. So are there roadblocks? There are, it's just the way it is. So I will tell you quite honestly, I had my script, I sent it into something called the blacklist because I didn't even have a representation anymore because it was like, oh, she's old, she's difficult, she's pain in the ass.
You have to mention because the blacklist is confusing.
Oh, yeah.
It's actually a good thing.
The blacklist is somewhere you send scripts and it's an industry, one of the highest standards, and they rate your script. Thank you.
Because it sounds bad.
It sounds bad, but it's not. They read your script. And so I didn't have any representation. So I sent it in after I finished writing it, which took me years. And I got a very high mark back, which was for my first draft, a really high mark. So it doesn't come easy. So I thought, okay, I have something here. And as I started to go down the road and I put pitch together and my sizzle reel and all that stuff, and I went into a very big network, one of the biggest. And I sat with a female executive, and she said, this is one of the best things I've read in a long time, and this is one of the best pitches I had, but I can't give you the money. And I said, why? She said, because you're a first-time female writer-director, and I just can't. She said, they won't give me the money for this. And I thought, okay. But I really appreciate how honest she was mm-hmm. with me. She said, but you go make this. You go do it. Nobody else. You go do it. Because they'll try and take it from you. You go do it. I was offered $5 million to let a male direct it. I said, no. I was offered $5 million if I got a big name lead male. And when you see the movie, you'll see that the male role of the mafia dad, who's played brilliantly by Dominic Lombardozzi, you know, I was pushed to look at someone like Ethan Hawke, who is brilliant, brilliant. But he wasn't going to do this smaller part because it's a smaller role. But males, and everyone needs to know this, males bring money to a movie, not females. We're in 2024. Males. So there are a few women. That's why you see Nicole Kidman all the time. God bless her. But she'll fund your project, and that's amazing. But there's not many that do. Like, there's a price tag on everyone's head, basically. So to hear that, and the person that offered the $5 million, if you get me someone like Ethan Hawke or someone like that, and I said, I don't need $5 million. I don't need $5 million. I need maybe two. What about that for my girls? It was like, nope. Girls don't sell movies. And that's just the way it is. That's just the truth. But then you go on and you do this by yourself, which I did, funding it and all the other stuff. And then you get a beautiful product. And then you win awards and have an amazing festival run to only get to the other end. And then distribution also says, girls don't sell movies. So girls don't make movies, girls don't sell movies, girls don't fund movies. And you sit there saying, what do we do? What do we do? What is it what is our capability? What should we be doing? Because here's a beautiful product. And here's the first of its kind in the genre. So where do we sit here? That's why it is so vital for women and anybody who cares about any kind of equality or just human stories to get out, come see the movie, come support independent films, because this is not even a woman-male issue. This is about having a voice for everyone and all stories mattering, because they do. They all matter. And to say that, oh, you don't have a star, so no one's gonna care, is not correct. We won the audience award in the Hamptons Film Festival, which is a huge festival, against every single movie that was nominated for an Oscar. And the audience picked us. Why? Was it because we had stars? No, it was because it's a human story. And it's a story that's connecting to people. So
I think you touched on, this is the stuff. You played the daughter.
Yes, so fortunate to even have the opportunity to be a part of this, because it's so rare for a role this complex, this layered, to be written at all, at least in an opportunity that I would have the opportunity to read.
Any of us, which is why I wrote it, because female roles are underwritten.
And especially for a young girl, you never see it without it being, and you talked about it earlier, the aspect of female rage, and it's something that I've experienced. Every person I know is experienced, but you don't see it, so you feel like there might be something wrong with you. Like, am I angry? Does that make me
well, they
bad
tell you
person?
You're angry.
And Rose is such a complicated... I mean, it scared me when I got the part, because I had so many ideas. It just flew off the page as soon as I read it. and the responsibility of saying, will I be able to show people what I think? Because immediately I knew if I can get this part, like, I need to tell this story. I remember when I was in the callback, I was nervous because it's scary. And normally you do it, you say bye, and that's it. But I just had this like really powerful urge, which you never do, to be like, hold on, there's so much more. I need to do this again, which is a kind of crazy thing to do as an actor.
And then she broke open.
And then, because it felt like I needed to take my opportunity to get the chance to tell the story, and I really think that we did, and...
We sure did. You did.
And the layers of this character, it's so rare to have one come around, and at this point in my career when I'm just starting, I mean, it's life-changing for me, because now I understand why I want to tell stories. And how
that means
when
a lot
people
to me.
Come back after you sit down in a screening and girls my age come up to me because they decided to pop in and they say, I exactly feel that way.
I have to say, and I wish you could have been there. So we've like I said, we've gone and we've done a lot of screenings. We did a lot of different things. And there's women and men and people of all ages that come up to me. However, we just had a screening, a very small screening, that was hosted privately by someone, and it was women, young women, like 18
to
25, young. And I never heard an audience so quiet, and I actually was nervous. I said, I wonder if this is not their jam. I can't even tell you what I got after it. They needed it like they needed oxygen. They were crying, but moved, but like energized and inspired. I cannot, because what do the young women have today? They get these violent horror movies or silly, nonsense comedies, love stories, or they get, you know, like a Marvel. Like, where are there complicated young women dealing with the world? I can't even tell you how I wish you were there, because these young women, it really, really was one of the more moving audiences ever.
No, there's no denying the fact that people have been affected, and people my age that see Rose and say, well, that's how I felt. I mean, it makes sense to me, because when I read the script, I said, this makes sense my head.
And from all ages, like she's telling me about the rage, but
that's just my experience. And
it's across the board, because you do experience that in this film. But I will say, there's a female filmmaker that came over to me, a well-known female filmmaker who came over to me at Tribeca. And she said to me, Tribeca Film Festival is where we premiered the movie. And she came over to me and she said, I have to tell you, I just watched your film and I'm blown away. She said, but I'm also blown away at my reaction, because there's something in the movie that you'll see, and it's a violent piece, but it's from the girls. And she said, I really had a hard time. And I had to ask myself, why did I have a hard time? She said, because I wasn't comfortable seeing women behave that way. And I had to look at myself and say, why? Because we are not allowed to express that. We're not supposed to. We're supposed to stay cute and polite and kind and pretty and dainty, and that is for them. But we have that. And she said, I had to look at myself, because you push that button, and that's what's interesting to me. That's what's art. That is art, because it'll make you go home and think, what am I avoiding? What am I not looking at? What am I doing? That is what art's supposed to be. And that is why it has been a struggle for this film. Because I don't know if they want you to see that. So you need to go and watch the film.
Please come watch it.